Eugene Ockerland. Eugene Arthur Ockerland, December 19, 1942 January 2, 2019, better known by his ring name Mean Gene Ockerland, was an American professional wrestling interviewer, announcer, and television host. He was best known for his work in the World Wrestling Federation and World Championship Wrestling. Ockerland was inducted into the WWE Hall of Fame in 2006 by Hulk Hogan. He was signed to a lifetime contract with WWE and worked for promotional programs, mostly WWE Network programming and, occasionally, the TV series. Professional career. Early career. After studying broadcast journalism at the University of Nebraska, Lincoln, Ockerland landed a job as a disc jockey at KOIL, a popular radio station in Omaha, Nebraska. Ockerland later moved to Minneapolis where he worked for WDGY as a radio host under the alias of Gene Leader. He later left that position to become program director at KWDB. Ockerland also worked in Minneapolis for a local television station in the front office. Ockerland fronted the band Gene Carroll and the Shades releasing Is It Ever Gonna Happen on the album In This Corner Norton Records in 1962. American Wrestling Association, 1970-1984. Ockerland left the radio industry for a position at the American Wrestling Association, AWA, in 1970, where he occasionally filled in for ailing ring announcer and interviewer Marty O'Neill, eventually becoming O'Neill's permanent replacement by the end of the decade. World Wrestling Federation, 1984-1993. He stayed with the AWA until the end of 1983, when he was one of many AWA personnel to join the expanding World Wrestling Federation, WWF. He stayed with the WWF for 9 years as their top interviewer and was host of such WWF shows as All American Wrestling and Tuesday Night Titans. In 1984, Ockerland and Hulk Hogan faced Mr. Fuji and George Steele in Minneapolis. He was supposed to stay on the apron and let Hogan fight, but when Hogan gave him a high five, the referee mistook it for a tag. Ockerland had to go in, but before his opponent touched him, he quickly got out of the way and tagged Hogan back in. Ockerland pinned Mr. Fuji for the victory. Ockerland was also part of one of the most infamous bloopers in professional wrestling history at SummerSlam in 1989. Ockerland was set to interview WWF Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion Ravishing Rick Rude and Rude's manager Bobby Heenan prior to Rude's title defense against The Ultimate Warrior when the SummerSlam backdrop fell backwards. The shot of the SummerSlam backdrop falling can be seen in the video induction of Mean Gene at the WWE Hall of Fame in 2006. Ockerland then turned around and said, "Fuck it," along with some other words with no audio. The cameras then cut away to a live shot of the crowd, with play-by-play announcer Tony Schiavone and color commentator Jesse Ventura attempting to restore order. After a short while, Ockerland's interview with Rude and Heenan went as planned. According to a shoot interview with Ockerland, conducted by RF Video, the SummerSlam blooper was actually taped beforehand. Ockerland explained that the wrong tape was aired during the live broadcast. Meanwhile, a frantic Vince McMahon was on a headset instructing Ventura to cover for Ockerland. Ventura instead made fun of Ockerland's on-air gaffe and jokingly regarded Ockerland as a troublemaker. World Championship Wrestling, 1993-2001. Ockerland appeared at SummerSlam 1993 and made his final WWF appearance on the September 18, 1993 edition of Superstars. He then left the WWF entirely when his contract expired. He stated in an RF shoot interview that although he probably could have renegotiated a new contract, he was never actually offered one, thus opting to become an interviewer for World Championship Wrestling, WCW. He claimed at the time of his hiring with WCW that he had not been on speaking terms with McMahon for the past few years he was working in the WWF. He debuted on the November 6, 1993 edition of WCW Saturday Night. 3 years later, his contract expired with WCW and he was off television for 2 months in the fall of 1996. His final appearance was at WCW Fall Brawl on September 15, 1996. Åkerlund had talks with the WWF during this time, however, they could not come to terms. Mike Tenay took over special interviews and the pay-per-view reports. Åkerlund signed a new contract with WCW and returned on the November 11, 1996 edition of WCW Monday Nitro. Åkerlund wrestled twice in WCW. The first was in mid-2000 when he and Buff Bagwell faced Chris Kenyon and fellow announcer Mark Madden, with Bagwell and Åkerlund winning. However, Madden wanted Åkerlund back in the ring the next week in a one-on-one matchup. The two did wrestle again and Åkerlund won the match with the assistance of Pamela Paulshock. After that, he was with WCW until January of 2001. Returned to the WWF/WWE, 2001-2018. Shortly before WWF's purchase of WCW in 2001, Åkerlund rejoined his old promotion, renamed WWE in 2002. His first assignment back with WWF was the gimmick Battle Royal during WrestleMania X7 on April 1, 2001, along with Bobby the Brain Heenan. He hosted WWE Confidential in 2002, which lasted for 2 years. Åkerlund also hosted WWE Madison Square Garden Classics, a weekly series, airing on the Message Network, featuring classic WWE matches that took place at Madison Square Garden from the last 4 decades. He's also the host for the WWE Classics On Demand Hall of Fame section, which takes a look at a different WWE Hall of Famer each month. Åkerlund was inducted into the WWE Hall of Fame on April 1, 2006, by Hulk Hogan. In June 2008, Åkerlund began hosting WWE Vintage Collection, a program which showcases archive footage from the extensive WWE video library. Åkerlund conducted the interviews on the 3-hour old school episode of Raw on November 15, 2010, where he interviewed John Cena, Randy Orton, members of the Nexus and Mae Young in similar fashion as to how interviews were done in the 1980s. Åkerlund also appeared in a few old school merchandising segments, promoting WWE's new old school merchandise line. On April 10, 2012, during the WWE SmackDown, Blast from the Past, Åkerlund teamed with World Heavyweight Champion Sheamus, in a winning effort, against the team of Daniel Bryan and Alberto Del Rio. On the December 17, 2012 edition of WWE Raw, Åkerlund appeared alongside Jim Ross and Ricky the Dragon Steamboat to announce the winner of the Slammy Award for Match of the Year. On March 4, 2013, Åkerlund appeared at the second old school Raw for Mae Young's 90th birthday party, which was interrupted later by CM Punk. On January 7, 2014, Åkerlund made an appearance at the third old school Raw, in which he made references to the premium rate wrestling hotlines of the 1980s and 1990s. In November 2016, Åkerlund became the narrator for the WWE Network original animated series WWE Storytime. On January 22, 2018 at Raw 25 Years, Åkerlund made his final WWE appearance where he interviewed AJ Styles. Other media. On November 12, 1985, Åkerlund, along with Hulk Hogan, Bobby Heenan, Ricky Steamboat, David Boy Smith, Corporal Kirchner, Dynamite Kid, and Big John Studd, appeared on the A-Team. Åkerlund was one of the professional wrestling legends on the WWE Network's show Legends House. Åkerlund appeared as a celebrity prognosticator on ESPN Radio's The Dan L.E. Battard Show with Stigotz on November 27, 2013. In 2018, Åkerlund appeared in a Mountain Dew Kickstart commercial featuring Kevin Hart, who during the commercial semi-impersonated Randy Savage. He made an appearance at the WrestleCade 2018 weekend event that took place November 23 to 25, 2018 in Winston-Salem, North Carolina. Personal life. Forming a band in his high school days, Gene Carroll and the Shades were based out of Sisseton, South Dakota, recording a single in 1959, Red Devil / Do You Remember, MNL 1001. A second single was released in 1962, Is It Ever Gonna Happen / Holly, Wausau C1100, as Jean Carroll. They played parties throughout the Midwest and the Dakotas, and in 2009 were inducted into the South Dakota Rock and Roll Music Association's Hall of Fame. In his AWA days, Åkerlund was given the nickname Mean Gene by Jesse the Body Ventura, an irony, considering that throughout the years many wrestlers and promotion staff considered Åkerlund the friendliest person in the game. Åkerlund was close friends with Hulk Hogan, the Iron Sheik, and the late Bobby Heenan. Åkerlund served as best man at the Iron Sheik's wedding. His name has been associated with fast food concept, Mean Gene's Burgers, the brainchild of food distributor Orion Food Systems, headed by two of Åkerlund's nephews, which appeared on college campuses including Duke University and West Virginia University, as well as Mean Gene's Pizza, a chain of pizzerias located within bowling alleys. Mean Gene's Burgers locations are also located at select overseas U.S. Navy base eatery locations, e.g. United States Fleet Activities Yokosuka. These are owned by Hot Stuff Foods, which was headed by two of his nephews. Early in 2006, Åkerlund and Hot Stuff split. Åkerlund and one of the nephews were planning to start their own food company on the brands, but Hot Stuff sued, claiming they had Mean Gene trademarked. Åkerlund lost, with the judge saying that Åkerlund can't use the name Mean Gene for his new food company. Åkerlund succeeded in canceling the trademark registrations held by Orion, but remained enjoined from competing with Orion for the remainder of his life. Åkerlund had been married to his wife Jean since March 27, 1964 and had two sons and three grandsons. His son Todd starred on the University of Minnesota ice hockey team from 1983 to 1987. Todd played on the 1988 United States Olympics team that competed in Calgary. He played four games with the NHL's New York Islanders. A chronic knee injury ultimately forced his early retirement. In his later years, Åkerlund suffered from polycystic kidney disease. Åkerlund, who was a heavy drinker for most of his adult life, had received three kidney transplants. His first was in 1995 and his second in 2004, the latter of which he received from his wife. Death. Åkerlund died on the morning of January 2, 2019, at the age of 76 in a Sarasota, Florida hospital. This was later confirmed on WWE social media and its official website later that day. It was revealed by his son, Todd Åkerlund, that he had received three kidney transplants and had suffered a fall which caused his health to deteriorate in the weeks leading up to his death. Condolences were sent by fellow WWE superstars and alumni on all social media including Triple H, Ric Flair, Hulk Hogan, Iron Sheik, Stone Cold Steve Austin and Dwayne The Rock Johnson, among many others. Awards and accomplishments.